This is what I say to everyone who says I should play Fortnite. I'm not going to deal with it. Hey, what's up, soldiers? My name is Greg FPS, the Zombies Extraordinaire, and welcome back to another Zombies video that is not Fortnite. Sorry, I had to throw that in. That meme is hilarious. But anyways, guys, I hope you are all having an amazing day. Today, what I have for you guys is going to be the top 5 worst ways to die, episode number 5. Now, this is a weekly series I've been doing. Obviously, this is the 5th week, and I'm really, really enjoying this one. It's a lot of fun, and I have another awesome one planned that I'm going to be uploading on Saturdays, starting pretty soon as well. But anyways, guys, I wanted to mention that if you have any horrible ways to die that you don't think I've mentioned in any of these episodes, make sure to comment them down below, because I love making this series and ranting about some of these. They're absolutely hilarious. We got another full-fledged episode of awesome, well, they're not really awesome when it happens to you, but great ways to die that really piss people off. So anyways, guys, without further ado, if you do enjoy, make sure to drop a like, subscribe if you're new, and turn on notifications. And coming in at the number 5 spot is going to be from my boy I Am Wolfie, the speed run god himself, and he said forgetting to get a shield. So yes, this is definitely an important one, because usually it seems like when it happens to me, I totally forget to get a shield and I'm the one building it. So I like build the shield by holding square and then I forget to grab one and then I don't end up having a shield. Also, just forgetting to get one in general is really, really bad in Black Ops 3 and in some cases Black Ops 2. If you have the shield, it literally protects your back so much, and it's super, super important for a lot of main things, especially when you're doing Easter eggs. Even on Mob of the Dead, when you go on the bridge and you have the shield on your back, it helps if you're the one training around Brutus and all the zombies and someone standing back throwing tomahawks. So getting the shield is a huge essential part of Call of Duty Zombies and what it's become for Treyarch, at least. So forgetting to get a shield is definitely something that is a big issue, and it causes a lot of people to go down. The only problem with this is if we end up getting maps in the future that don't have shields, would it change the way we play because we're so used to getting shields? It kind of seems like a crutch in a sense, kind of like how Gobblegums in Black Ops 3 make it so easy, and then when you go back on older CODs, they're not there to make everything easy and a breeze. So just keep that in mind, but definitely forgetting to get a shield, especially in like Black Ops 3, is definitely something that I think is a horrible way to go down, by just getting hit in the back thinking you have a shield and you don't. Coming in at the number 4 spot is a comment from Cyrax803, who commented, suffocation on Moon. So obviously when we're talking about Black Ops 3, going into Moon, you are already off at a disadvantage because you have Widow's Wine instead of PhD. So Widow's Wine can knock out some of the windows, causing you to freeze. And although it's not realistic, if you want realistic, just go over to Battlefield. At least that's what people used to say. But you're literally screwed at that point once you break the windows in the lab, in the starting room where Quick Revive is on Moon, like literally on the moon, not no man's land. So that makes it really, really tough, because for example, you have to hack the control panels, and if you have a hacker device, you don't have your PES. So you have to hack it in just the amount of time to get back out into the airlock so you can actually breathe and get a PES system. So this can be really, really difficult. Also, just running through the labs and possibly get trapped by a zombie and or hit by a zombie, you break those windows as well. Then you have to make your way fairly far with a hacker device if you don't have a PES system on. So this is definitely a huge issue. Sometimes people completely forget as well. I know it's happened to me on Moon where I have the hacker device, I don't have a PES, and the biodome already got, you know, decompressed, and I accidentally step on the jump pad thinking that I'm gonna be fine, and it already got decompressed. So I go flying, and then I don't have enough time to get back to the airlock and breathe. So this happens. It's a horrible way to die, but as long as you're playing smart and being cautious, you should be good. Coming in at the number 3 spot is from Menoba, who commented, falling into the water on the zipline step on Zets. So yes, this is definitely something that has happened to me before. I remember the first ever time I did the Zetsubou Easter egg, I ended up doing it solo, but I had quick revive and I accidentally launched myself off of the zip line too early and I fell in the water. Good thing I had quick revive because I got right back up and the game didn't end, obviously. But that was definitely something like really, really bad. I remember playing with friends as well. The same exact thing happened to me where I was like, you know what? I'll just do it. I don't really care if I lose or go down and have to restart and buy everything again. So I just ended up sacrificing myself. Boom, my friend misses it and we die again. So having a cog there kind of does suck, but I really do like it because it's definitely one of those steps that can literally make or break any game you have on Zetsubou, which I kind of like. It's kind of like one of those, you know, high risk, high reward type things where you need the cog. So you're definitely going to be risking it no matter what. But also if you end up playing perfectly and know exactly where to like hit the control panel with an electric shock shield, then you should be good. So definitely a really, really good step, I think, for the Easter egg, because it is fairly difficult if you don't really know how to do it properly. But then again, if you really are worried about it, you can launch from the bottom and that makes it so much easier because you can just have a much safer chance of doing it. So anyways, guys, that is definitely a good one. Falling into the water on the zipline step for the Zetsubou no Shima Easter egg. Definitely a fairly fun Easter egg. I did it yesterday on stream and we ended up making it, not failing, which was pretty surprising. So anyways, guys, that is definitely a really bad way to die though, because you completely lose everything, all your weapons, all your perks, and you die out if you're playing in a co-op game. Coming in at the number two spot is from Isma, who commented, playing Black Ops 2, Black Ops 1, World at War after a while and forgetting those games are a two hit down. So yes, this is something that happens to me all the time because, as you guys know, playing zombies and making zombies top fives and content all the time, I have to go back and play the older CODs, especially when it's like I need a certain weapon from like Black Ops 1 or Black Ops 2, for example, to make a video. So this actually happens to me a lot, so I'm kind of used to it at this point. But usually if someone, like one of my friends, decides he wants to help and we hop on like PC or whatever and we're gonna be just playing and, you know, doing an Easter egg or something, then they forget that it's a two-hit system. And I think that's kind of why I want Black Ops 4 to be a two-hit system. Now, don't get me wrong, some of you guys might not like that idea, and I can totally understand why. But overall, I think that it kind of created a huge crutch, kind of like what I mentioned in the beginning with the shields with Black Ops 3, because not only do you have three hits now, but you have overpowered perks and gobblegums that make it so much easier. And you really don't even have to worry about playing super aggressive. You can just play and have fun on Black Ops 3. And don't get me wrong, like I love gobblegums. I love the three hit system. It's really, really good. It saved me so many times. But at the same time, I think having a two hit system would make it more difficult to again, and that's why I like Black Ops 2 so much, and Black Ops 1 and World at War, which I think all had pretty much flawless zombies except for a few maps here and there. But overall, I just love everything about, you know, the older CODs. But I can completely understand when someone goes back, hasn't played it in a long time, and it's kind of the scapegoat of a lot of downs whenever I play with friends. Oh, I forgot it's a two-hit system, and I'm like, yeah, sure, okay. Yep, definitely, of course. So that is definitely a good one though. So that comes in at the number two spot. Thanks for commenting, Isma. And coming in at the number one spot is my buddy Sutton's Gameplay, who commented two words, connection interrupted. You're going to round 100 or something and then you get it. And when you come back, you're most likely dead. I mainly think of this when I think of the launch of Black Ops 3. You weren't even safe in solo match or even local play. Ugh, makes me mad every time I see it. So yes, connection interrupted is by far one of the most annoying things that a lot of people have to deal with, especially if you have really, really bad internet or you live in a rural area, that is definitely going to happen where you're going to get connection interrupted here and there. Even it happens all the time in public matches, and it is definitely an issue because usually you're just lagging all over the place. So you like basically aren't touching your controller and you're moving back and forth. You go somewhere and, you know, it kind of just like cancels everything out. The zombies stop moving, so you think, hey, you may be safe. And then when you get back and the connection is connected again, then you're down. And that is so frustrating. It definitely has happened to me a multitude of times, and I'm sure it's happened to a lot of people. It's not even if you have like amazing god tier internet, you can still get a connection interrupted because the host of the game just has a bad internet connection overall. So this mostly happens in public matches, but like Sutton said, at the launch of Black Ops 3, you had to be connected to even do solo matches, and you still do unless you're playing local. So this can definitely happen as well, and it's a huge issue. So anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching. I hope you guys did enjoy this video, and if you did, make sure to drop a like, subscribe if you're new, and make sure to subscribe for some more zombies content that is not Fortnite. Peace out, dudes.